Hello and welcome to the International Daily Roundup with People's Dispatch, where we bring you some of the top stories from across the globe. Let's take a look at today's headlines. Colombian movements convene the National People's Assembly as strike continues. Pedro Castillo poised to win Peru's election as vote count nears end. New Zealand's health workers go on strike for fair pay and safe conditions. Government workers enter fourth week of strike amid police repression in Lesotho, and in our video section, we take a look at 6 years of the Ni Una Menos movement against gender-based violence. Colombia's social movements convened the National People's Assembly in the city of Bogota this week. It is composed of workers, Afro-Colombian and indigenous communities and rural peasant movements. Starting June 6, they met for 3 days to discuss ways to strengthen the ongoing struggle. The assembly will now present a series of joint proposals, agreements and a mobilization agenda. In the meantime, people have continued to take to the streets as part of the national strike. Social movements have argued that they have not found proper representation in the National Strike Committee. Negotiations between the committee and the government have been stalled since last month. The committee has now called for intensified protests on June 9th. This is to pressurize the government to sign the pre-agreement announced in May. People have been demanding guarantees for social protests and an end to police brutality. Meanwhile, the government has responded by deploying the military and increased violence by the police. Rights groups Indepaz, Temblores and PES have recorded 3,798 cases of police violence between April 28th and May 31st. At least 41 people have been killed and there have been 25 reported cases of sexual violence. 356 people have also been forcibly disappeared. Another 42 people were also killed in 9 massacres across Colombia during this time. The Inter-American Commission on Human Rights has arrived in the country to examine the rights violations. It will be meeting with the National Strike Committee on June 9th. Peru's left-wing presidential frontrunner, Pedro Castillo, declared victory on the night of June 8th. Speaking to supporters in Lima, he asked voters to remain vigilant in the final hours of the election process. While the counting of votes is still underway as of 9 a.m. local time, an official result is expected soon. With 99.79% of the votes counted, Castillo from the Free Peru Party has won 50.2% of the votes. Meanwhile, far-right candidate Keiko Fujimori from the Popular Force Party has a vote share of 49.79%. Around 30,000 nurses, midwives and healthcare assistants held a countrywide strike in New Zealand on June 9th. The strike took place after the New Zealand Nurses Organization rejected a third pay offer made by the district health boards. Nurses and other health workers have been mobilizing against low wages and understaffing. Strike notices were first issued on May 14th after nurses rejected 2 agreements offered in February and March. Most non-urgent and outpatient care services were cancelled on Wednesday as health workers began the 8-hour strike. Marches were held in places like Auckland, Hamilton City and Dunedin, among other places. Hundreds of people also gathered outside the Parliament building following a march in Wellington. Chants of fair pay, safe staffing could be heard. Picket lines were also set up outside hospitals in several areas. The government's latest offer was made on May 27, including a lump sum payment of $4,000. However, this amount would be a portion of the back pay already owed to the workers through their ongoing pay equity claims. The union also stated that the current pay rise would only amount to 1.38% per year. The hike for midwives would be 1.25%, which is below the annual inflation rate of 1.7%. Workers are demanding a 17% pay increase, safe staffing protocols, and an additional 5 days of sick leave. According to a December 2020 report by the NZNO, 250 unsafe staffing incidents took place in Auckland in 3 months. Negotiations are expected to continue after the strike. However, the government has stated that it will not be able to provide the demanded pay increase, citing pandemic-related constraints. Prime Minister Ardern also indicated a possible 3-year wage freeze in May. In our next story, we go to Lesotho, where garment and textile workers have entered their fourth week on strike. Nearly 95% of the 40,000 workers in the sector have downed their tools since May 14th. Organized by a coalition of trade unions, they are protesting the non-renewal of wages for 2 years. The United Textile Employees Union has stated that the government has failed to hike wages despite prices rising by around 20%. Meanwhile, wages have remained stagnant at $150 per month since 2019. No agreement was reached during the negotiations in 2020, following which the government decided not to gazette any hike at all. As negotiations resumed in February this year, the Employers Association offered a 5% hike. Meanwhile, workers demanded a 20% increase proportionate to rising prices. However, the government once again decided not to renew wages. Workers held demonstrations in the capital of Maseru and the town of Maputo on May 14th. However, police soon reached the scene and attacked workers with tear gas, rubber bullets and batons. Police opened fire again on May 17th, injuring several workers, including one in the eye and another in their knees. The Unite Union reported that one worker was killed after being hit by a truck while being chased by the police. The government informed workers on May 25th that it would invite the ILO to mediate the issue following days of repression and government delays. The government established a committee of five ministers on May 26th. The Prime Minister also announced that a gazette notifying the wage hike will be issued by June 14th. Workers have stated that they will remain on strike till the notification is published. And for a final story, we take a look at the Ni Una Menos movement in Argentina. June 3rd marked 6 years since the start of the struggle against femicide and other forms of gender-based violence. The movement has spread across Latin America to include a broad range of interconnected social struggles. Here is the video feature on 6 years of Ni Una Menos. We'll be right back. And that is all we have for this episode of the International Daily Roundup. For more such stories and videos, visit our website peoplesdispatch.org, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Thank you for watching.